Tonight on 2020, is your home a death trap? Geraldo Rivera exposes the fiery danger of aluminum wiring, plus anorexia, the disease that causes young women to starve themselves. And Video Rock, new technology turns your home into a concert hall. Next.
And affluent teenagers plunking down money. $3 for an album in 1950, then $5, $6, and now $9 following inflation. It's big, the record business. Bigger than movies. Bigger than sports. And it's in trouble. Turmoil, confusion. The growth has slowed. That has happened before, and there's always been a superseller to pull sales up. Crosby, Presley, the Beatles, and the rock superstars of the 70s. Rock could do no wrong. Records turned to gold overnight. Lavish parties. A limousine for every star, fantastic expectations, and a forced market, overpressing, overshipping. And then the reckoning. Tastes wavered. Retailers returned records by the millions, and record makers searched for reasons.
Records you don't have to buy, really, to hear music. There's sensational equipment out there, there's great FM radio, there's enormous amount of music available without having to buy a record. Counterfeiting, home taping, and the failure of major artists to deliver records on some kind of regular basis.
Companies folded, merged, fired workers, and a crackdown on counterfeiting began. No more illegal copying of records. Executives of one of the biggest and oldest retailers, Sam Goody, were charged with conspiring with counterfeiters. And the record makers began looking for new super sounds. They tried groups like Fleetwood Mac.
Their big record, Tusk, last fall, was expected to bring people back to the stores.
Well, it didn't work. Now they're turning to new technology, new sounds with pictures to help restore the golden growth of profits. And here's Steve Fox with a report on that hope. Steve?
Hugh, we're talking about the video disc. Sales are just beginning, and the record companies are searching for the right kind of images to put on the discs to make you want to own them. Now, maybe the best way to talk about what may be the future is to look at the past.
Thomas Edison gave birth to the recording industry more than a century ago with an invention for documenting people's wills, but recorded music soon followed.
Hallelujah Chorus from the Messiah, played by the Edison Concert Band.
In 1889, Edison's original wax recording cylinder gave way to the 78 RPM record, which was adopted by operatic and classical musicians as a way to sell their talents to people at home, not at live concerts. In the late 1940s came two innovations. Columbia developed a 33 RPM album, known ever after as the LP, and RCA introduced its rival 45 RPM record.
Changes records fast, doesn't it?
You bet.
Tone.
The last major development in home musical entertainment was stereo sound, demonstrated here by Buster Keaton in the mid-1950s. Now comes the newest development in home entertainment, the video disc, technological child of a show business marriage.
Hollywood is much more interested right now than they've ever been before in the musical talent combining with the visual images. The videotape disc, which is emerging very rapidly, is perhaps going to be the culmination of that marriage which has been building for a number of years.
Somewhere, somehow, somebody must have kicked you around, son. Who knows, maybe you were kidnapped, tied up, taken away, and held for ransom.
Rock music generates the largest chunk of record sales, and ever since the mid-1970s, companies have been making promotional tapes and experimenting with a number of different ways to put pictures to music. This is the most common, songs illustrated simply by showing groups in performance, like Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers.
Hey,
A second method uses high technology to illustrate music, like the computer-generated special effects added to this performance by Kate Bush.
Rolling through the streets, looking for a disco, passing up the treats from a kid named Cisco.
The third approach involves the narrative telling of a fictional story with both pictures and music, as Mike Nesmith does in Cruisin'. This is one of the best examples of how good visuals, cleverly combined with fair to middling music, produces a total package that's better than either element alone, perhaps because the images are drawn from fantasy and not mere reality.
And Lucy and Ramona were trying to figure out if he was gay.
There's much debate among record executives about whether video represents the future of the industry, but Joe Smith of Elektra Asylum Records says there's no such debate among his biggest stars.
That our major artists are people like Queen, Eagles, Jackson Brown, Linda Ronstadt, Joni Mitchell, artists like that, The Cars. Everyone wants to do video right now.
Ron Hayes is a video artist who's been collaborating with some record companies.
The intelligent ones recognize that it's a marriage between the visual artist and the musician at this point, that it takes experimentation and it takes looking at how much you can stretch the medium to make something creative. The man or the woman who finds the right combination will take it all.
One musician is so interested in finding that right combination that he spent a reported $2 million building a video production studio near his home in upstate New York. Here, Todd Rundgren used $150,000 worth of development money from RCA's video disc division to visualize the music from this synthesized version of Holst's Planets. Pure classical music is expected to command a small share of the video disc market. Of course, not everyone in the record business believes that the marriage of video and music will work.
I don't really think that it's likely that it will have an effect upon music, because though the large public that is into music is into the repetition of music, the tremendous buy of records is the fact that for a few dollars you could have something for a lifetime.
The problem I think that people aren't addressing themselves to is, what can you stand to watch 1,000 times? If you're going to spend even $30 or $20 for a videotape or an audio or a video disc, how many times can you watch it?
It seems the biggest problem facing video discs is repeatability. What would you want to watch more than once? Well, an interesting British study has found that the most repeatable kind of image for adults is pornography. And for kids, it's cartoons. This video song by a group called the Do-Rocks, combining cartoon-like humor with sexual overtones, should therefore have great repeatability, and in fact, this was voted the number one video song by some cable TV viewers in a poll conducted by Mike Nesmith, who may have the best understanding of the video record's potential.